Hello, Virgo. My name is Agatha and my email is duniaza@gmail.com. So let's see what is the prediction for you, Virgo, for November 2018. We are going to start with the astrology prediction. And on the 7th of November 2018, there's a new moon at 15 degrees of Scorpio, and it's going to be on your third house, so you're going to get a lot of messages. Maybe these messages are pertaining to your creative endeavors. For others, it has to do with the fact that you either became a parent, you know, a mother, a father, or you just found out that you're pregnant, or your spouse or your partner is pregnant. Or if it's not that, maybe it has to do with your sister or your brother. Maybe he or she, you know, just got a baby and you just, you know, you're a new aunt or a new uncle. So this could be, like I said, a brand new beginning connected with your sister or with your brother. I'm thinking it's more sister. This could be some sort of, you know, a course that you decide to do, classes, like creative classes, or maybe you decide to, maybe you have a boyfriend or a girlfriend and he or she is from, I don't know, Finland, and you decide to take, to learn a new language because you want to speak to your boyfriend or your girlfriend in his or her native language. What else? This could be a car that you decide to buy, that you need to buy, and you are absolutely in accordance, I mean, you are in agreement with your spouse connected with buying this new car. Others, it could be, you know, there's a new neighbor in your, you have new neighbors, okay? It could also be the messages that you're getting are connected with your son or daughter, maybe because he or she just got like this fantastic prize, and you know, something very positive happened, and the messages that you're getting is that, oh my god, I saw your son, I saw your daughter, she won the spelling bee, I don't know, something like that, and so this is why everyone is, you know, calling you or messaging you. So on the 23rd of November, Virgo, you have a full moon at 0 degrees of Gemini in your 10th house. So this is not a very, it's a difficult full moon because it's squaring Mars in Pisces in the 7th house, and it's being opposed by Jupiter in Sagittarius in the 4th house, which also squares Mars in the 7th. So Jupiter is a planet that expands everything, okay? So it could expand good things and bad things. So it's going to depend from natal chart to natal chart. Especially if you were born in the beginning of Virgo, like in the beginning signs of Virgo, I can't recall, maybe late August. This might be difficult for you, okay? Because this is going to affect your sun as well. So for some of you, it's the end of a career, you know. Again, 2 weeks prior, you were getting a lot of messages. Maybe you were getting a lot of messages because you found out that, for instance, finally you get to retire, Virgo, you know. Finally you get to retire and everyone is congratulating you because of that. Something very good happened in your, let's say, second career. Let's say you have another career, a freelance job or freelance work that you do creatively, and suddenly you have a lot of works, you have a lot of clients to work with, and you have to absolutely leave your 9-to-5 job in order to, you know, fully devote yourself to this freelance career, and everyone is telling you they're so happy for you, you know. Not everyone is happy for you, but anyway, what else? So you maybe, some of you might even be moving from one career into another career. Again, it could be that people are like saying, and you found out maybe 2 weeks ago, and now around 23rd of November is when you finally leave, and you used to do a certain type of work. Now I'm going to do another type of work. Let's say that you used to be an accountant. I don't know. I'm just, you know, throwing that. I have no idea. But now I'm going to sell real estate. Now I'm going to move to another country and sell real estate, or you're going to sell real estate to foreign people who have lots and lots of money. I don't know. And just, or just, are you just, you know, finally, some wealthy relative just left you a fortune. Now you don't have to work anymore. You know, it could be that as well. What else? I would say an uncle, maybe. What else could it be? Or you could be moving to another job, not necessarily another career, but you're going to move to another job and you're going to be paid very well. Your spouse or your partner might not like it all that much because there's a square to Mars in Pisces on the seventh house. He or she might try to use emotional blackmail in order to for you not to be all that happy with this change in your career. Because it might affect him or her, but he or she might be telling you one thing, it might be, you know, behaving in another way. So the message that you're getting from your spouse or even a potential business partner are two different types of messages. You know, they say one thing, but they're lying to you. If this is not a spouse or, you know, a partner or a business partner, this could be a open enemy who's trying to be hidden, but very fast I would say that you discover who this enemy is, because this person might be spreading lies about you, okay? And they might be, I think they're jealous because of your good fortune, of your the money. This is connected with money. They're jealous of the money that you're going to earn. They're jealous. This is financial jealousy. This is the jealousy that they have. What else? This could also be, if you're not retiring, maybe it's a boss who's leaving. You know, there's a boss who's leaving, and around the 23rd of November, maybe you're getting a new boss. This new boss might be younger and a foreigner. Or it could be someone in authority in your family, like mother, father, grandfather, grandmother is retiring. You know, someone like that is retiring. Could be even an uncle with whom you've always maybe who has always lived with you, Virgo, and this person is retiring. Okay, so there are many different ways of reading this lunation, and it's going to depend from natal chart to natal chart. And now I'm going to go to the card reading. So we are going to go to the card reading, Virgo, and I'm using the Chronicles of Destiny. Oh, you can see fortune cards, Chronicles of Destiny fortune cards. And this is called the story spread. And like for some of you, the astrology reading might make more sense, while for others, the card reading might make a little more sense. So the first card represents the theme for you, Virgo, for November 2018. And you have the dream catcher. The dream catcher catches nightmares, catches bad things. And it's a protective amulet. So this tells me that you're being protected. This is a protection message. Whatever happens in November 2018, you are always being protected. You are protected, so don't be afraid. Okay, Virgo? So the three cards below represent the story, the way the story will unfold during this month. You have the first card is Phoenix. Phoenix speaks of a major transformation in your life, of a major rebirth. And the next card following it is the Dragon. So this major transformation gives you nightmares, gives you fear, gives you anxiety. And after this big change, you don't know what to do. You don't know how to act, how to behave. Now, this big change could be, you know, big money. This could be retiring. This could be changing your career, something. But you're afraid, okay? And then finally, you have the Baroness, which speaks of a person in your midst. Could be a man or a woman who is deceitful, who's showing you a good, pleasant face, but he or she is lying to you. He or she does not have your greatest good in sight. This speaks of underhandedness, you know, of lying to you. showing you a nice face, but you know, on the background, this person is working against you. So it's like, it feels like for some of you that your fears of this brain, of this change, your fears kind of attract this person into your mists because you're so afraid. And it's like you're like making the poison up. The fear is the poison that's going up, and within this poison, metaphorically speaking, there's this person, man or a woman. And it's kind of, it feels like you're attracting this person because you're so afraid. It feels like that. For some of you, it's not. But whatever happens, you're always being protected. You are protected, okay? Now, other ways of reading this. Okay. This could also be, the Phoenix is a something, there's not a change that's happening in your life, but something, an old problem, an old person, old, not old, a former event, a situation from the past, a person from the past comes back into your life. And this person gives you great anxiety, or this situation gives you great anxiety. And this person is deceitful, okay? This is a very deceitful person. And you don't know how to handle it. This could even be a narcissist type of guy, a psychopath, like a sociopath type of guy, that type of person. And be aware that whatever happens, you're always being protected. You are protected, okay? This could be a situation that arises from the past that comes back to haunt you, you know. And you're asking help for from someone because you don't know how to handle this situation. And you're asking the help of someone who's showing you a nice face, who's showing you that you think that he or she is your friend, but this person is actively working against you. I don't know who this person is, okay? So, but again, whatever happens, you're being protected. Okay, Virgo? Okay, Virgo? So that's it, Virgo. This is the reading that I have for you for November 2018, and I hope you have a great month. Bye-bye.